Hey there, this is just a quick video to show you how to take my tote evap air cooler and turn it into an indirect tote evap air cooler. Indirect meaning we'll get the cool dry air instead of the cool humid air into the room. Alright, we're set to go. We got the water, it's all hooked up. We got the indirect part over here. So just for testing, I'm actually going to vent this into the house, and it'll work for a few minutes, probably a half an hour before it got humid in here. Alright, here it is. We got the cool humid air coming out here. We got the cool dry air coming out here. The radiator behind it tapped into the bottom. It's working perfect. There's your air temp, 67 Fahrenheit, 19.4 Celsius. Fin temp a little cooler, 66.5, 19.2. And the water, 55.5 Fahrenheit, 13 Celsius. Essentially how it works is these evap coolers always cool the water in the bottom of the tub. They chill that down the same way they do the chilled air right here. Except instead of using this air inside because it's a little humid, we'll pump that outside, probably put the whole unit outside here, then run the tubes inside through a window or something. Then we just siphon the cold water off the bottom and through the radiator, and then cools off the fins. You pull the air through just from your room through the cool fins, and you get cool air with no added humidity. And remember, these things only generally work in dry or semi-dry areas, so you don't feel the humidity anyway. So it essentially just feels like an AC unit, a vent of an AC unit. One thing you can do if you really want to get it cold, drop a couple ice packs in the bottom. Then you'll have the evap cooling plus what they call simple conduction cooling through the pad. It'll be super cold then. Check out those temps. 52, 53, 11, 11.8 Celsius. 46 on the fins. That's 8.4 Celsius, and on the air, mid-50s. It's hitting the motor when it's hotter like that. Mid-50s now on the air. Check that out, 46 Fahrenheit, 7.8 Celsius. 48.5, 9.2. Cheating a little bit, got the ice packs in there right now, but I just wanted to see how cool I could get the air coming out of here. Then to make the conversion on the unit so we can get the cool dry air instead of cool humid air, all you need is the four things: a fan, a radiator, extra tubing, and an extra small pump. The reason this works is because not only does the air cool as it's going through the pad, But because most of the water doesn't actually evaporate but just gets to the bottom, it super cools the water too, so it's constantly cooling the water in the bottom down to the same temperature that it's cool in the air. So what we're going to do is just siphon off some of that water through a radiator to cool the fins down, and then we'll add a fan either in front or behind this and pull the room air through or push it through the radiator, and it'll create the cool dry air. That's how it works, basically. And then, of course, you have to vent this to the outside because you don't want to feel this. But that's pretty easy to do with this unit. You can just put this in a window facing the other way out. Or just put this right outside the window and then through a small notch in the screen or something, run these inside. So we'll keep this part inside, this part outside. That's it. That's the whole deal. Super smooth water flow now, not seeing any bubbles at all. Nice. Get the fan back on here. And you gotta have the lid on so it doesn't pull the air from the top. Let's see. Fits right on. Awesome. Again, one of the pumps is AC, one is DC. This is a DC fan and an AC fan, so I'm kind of mixing it 50-50. But you can do it all AC, all DC, whatever you want. On the DC, I just got a transformer plugged in, so really it's all pulling ultimately to AC, but that's just kind of like what I had available to set up. By the way, if you switch that pump to DC and the fan to DC right there, then the whole thing's 12-volt DC. Then you can drop it on a 12-volt battery or a 12-volt solar panel. If you're going to do solar panel, just to make sure you get the amps and everything all day long for good strong cooling, go with like a 75-watt or 100-watt panel. You'll get the amps on for everything you need. Otherwise, you could go with a deep cycle battery. The whole thing again is just 39 watts as it is right now. 15 watts that pump, 5 watts for the smaller pump, 10-watt fan, 9-watt fan. So 3940 watts runs the whole thing, and it should be whether you do AC or DC about that. Not bad at all for two little coolers. If you're lucky, you might be able to use this cooler outside somewhere. If you have a deck or a patio or a picnic table right outside, you can blow that on those. Or if you're using solar panels, one idea would be to vent this down towards the panels to keep them cool for better efficiency. But this is the part you use inside, of course. It's awesome. Totally cool. Then just add water as needed.